Hey everybody, today I'm going to show you how to change the mouse icon when somebody hovers over something inside of Storyline. It's a custom snippet that you have to add to an object, but then you have to grab an icon somewhere and adjust it there. So we're going to talk through that, how to preview it. You do have to preview it a little bit differently in JavaScript code and place the icon that you want somewhere. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo. Let's go ahead and dive in here. And you can follow along by going to learningdojo.ninja/javascript-snippets. This is where I keep all of my different Storyline JavaScript snippets. You can download the project file. At the time of this recording, I do not have the code updated. It will be slide 1.13. And so I'll have that up here. You could just copy and paste the code. And this one does not use any type of variable, so you don't need to create any variables or anything. What I want to do in this case, when the mouse hovers over this icon, is I want to change the cursor. I want to change the mouse icon to be something completely different. So you may be asking yourself, Jeff, why on earth would I want to do that? Well, this kind of came about after talking with someone at the ATD conference, one of the largest learning and development conferences out there. I presented a session on JavaScript and Storyline. Someone came up to me and said, hey, I really want to do this. And they wanted to teach somebody about accessibility, almost giving a perspective of somebody's view of when they hover over this mouse, that somebody may view it as upside down, or they may view it as you can have it like jump halfway across the screen or something like that. Mostly to help them, and in my mind at least, mostly to help them understand why accessibility is important and to give the learner a perspective of that type of thing. So I took that as a challenge of like, okay, how do I change the mouse icon? I've also seen like Camtasia do it, being able to move the cursor across and have like somebody's image or something across that. And you can change the cursor icon in Camtasia to whatever you want. So that was just the challenge that I had. And so I wanted to figure that part out. You can do that by coming into here. And then what we need to do is add a trigger to execute JavaScript when the timeline starts. Now, I do have a video that's talking about how to add animation to a card when you hover over it. And we used custom JavaScript to do a mouse over and a mouse out. One of the problems with Storyline is the events, we do have something instead of timeline starts, we could do a mouse hover over. And I could do this just through there. But the problem is I don't have a mouse hover out. Like as soon as it leaves there, I want to change it back to the normal cursor. So that's part of the problem. I could just stick with the mouse hover there and then add on custom code for mouse hover over, or I could just copy both in and just control it both there. And that's exactly what I'm doing. And in fact, you could just copy this code and I'll show you where to change it if you're not a coder and you just don't want to figure that part out. And then I'll go through and I'll kind of talk about what this code is doing. I just pasted it there. I'm going to hit okay. And then I could preview this, but we don't have our custom image in our Storyline package yet. This JavaScript will work, but it will not work until you've published it out. We'll come back to that. But one thing I forgot to mention is we do need to identify this object. And I've talked about this a lot in previous videos, but just for somebody who's new, I'm going to show you how to identify that object and get that ID. You just click on inspect when you preview it, and then you click on this little arrow icon and click there, and then it will show you the shape. It goes all the way down to the shape. There's the pathway. What I need to do is go up to the slide object. And so you can see right here, slide object, that data model ID, that's the ID that I need. In order to update this, if you're gonna do this on something else, you then just need to go into the code and replace that inside of those quotes. You basically just need to paste in the ID. That is one step that you will need to do. If you're not a coder, you don't care about what's happening here, you could just change out the ID and you're done. And you can just copy and paste that in, except for when you publish out. So stick around for that part. For those of you who want to dive in, let's go ahead and talk about what's happening here. If this target exists, and that's basically saying, if this object exists here, which it does, but that's just a way to protect it, is we're going to add an event listener of mouse over. So when somebody moves their mouse over that object, that's when this code is going to fire. Well, what code is going to fire? Well, we're going to say the target object, which in this case right here, we're going to change the style of the cursor, style.cursor. So style has a bunch of different properties, and we're talking specifically to the cursor. Now, what we will do is we will grab the URL, which a URL is basically a location. Typically, it's for a website, but it's the location of the website. This website is hosted on a server, and the reason why we say URL is because it's the location of where it's hosted and what file we're actually pointing to. In this case, we're pointing to .../. The code itself is going to be inside of a file called user.js. That user.js is stored inside of a folder called story_content. We want to look for this image one step above that folder. And so that's what that .... means. It's like, don't look in the same folder as what this user.js is. Go up a folder and look there, and we're going to have something called duck.png. I grabbed an icon from icon duck. I thought, might as well just grab a duck icon. So I searched for duck and downloaded that, and that is on my desktop as this duck.png. Now once I have that, I can go ahead and click OK, and then I can hit publish, and then publish this out to my desktop. Once I've published it out to my desktop, which in this case I did, you'll have this folder, and you'll just need to copy in your duck.png into that folder, just the main location. If this is a SCORM package, this works perfectly fine. You can still put this inside of the same spot that you see the story.html file. You can go ahead and just copy and paste that in. Now, here is the key. This will not run all the time locally, and it depends on the browser, so sometimes it may work. But if I was just to double-click on the story.html file, and if I was to hover over it, you could say, well, that's not working. That's broken. Sometimes this needs to be on a server. Again, it depends on the browser. And there's a lot of different ways to preview this on a server. One of my favorite ways is using Visual Studio Code. When you use Visual Studio Code, there is this Go Live, or Live Server is what it's called. And through the extensions, you can type in Live Server and install it. It's really that easy. You just type in Live Server here, install it, and then you get this Go Live button right here. With that open and your entire folder open, you just double click on the story.html file and you just click on Go Live. It's like creating your own little website here, your own little server here, and then code that normally needs a server to run will run just perfectly inside of here. I'm going to go ahead and hit resume. And now with that server running, if I hover over that object, there is my duck. You can change the icon. You could have like a little game where you're clicking on. Maybe it's like a little, I'm thinking like the Nintendo Duck Hunt. Maybe even like a target, or you're trying to, like a dart, and you're trying to throw the dart. You can change the cursor to that dart, and you can actually just click on it. And then once you click, you can change it back. And that's what that code, when I hover out of it, is doing. I come back into here, and I go ahead and preview. We're adding another mouse out, and we're changing this back to the default. We're changing it back to the default cursor. Otherwise, it's going to stay as that duck icon. And I'm not even sure if it'll stay when you go to the next page or not, but it will remain as that duck icon until something else triggers it to be a different type of cursor. And you can have that PNG be larger. You could also offset it. There's some code to offset it. So there's a lot that you can do with that. I just thought it was a fun little test to say, can I get the cursor to change similar to what is happening in Camtasia? And yes, you can. If you want to do that, there's the code. If you don't want to do that, that's fine. At least it's helping you practice some of your JavaScript inside of Storyline. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. Also, while you're at the channel, if you have any questions or you want to see other types of videos, go ahead and leave a comment down below. I also do have some merch. You can go ahead and check out a Learning Dojo official t-shirt as well as a hoodie. That also goes to help support my channel. If you want to check out my full website, you can also head on over to learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering anything learning development related. You can also download free templates, and those templates are in Articulate Storyline 360 or XAPI and video templates, as well as check out full courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. That's all I have for today, so thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.